Good morning. My name is Paramdeep Saturia. I'm a student of BTech CSC and my roll number is 11500. Today I'm going to give my presentations on vector clock. So let us understand why clocks are used in distributed systems. Clocks are used to order events among different processes and helps in implementing a protocol. Now let us understand why vector clocks are introduced. Lambert clocks have some disadvantages and in order to remove them, we learn the concept of vector clocks. So let us see the disadvantage of Lambert clock. Says if we have an event, A happens before B. So from this event, what we can deduce, the counter of A is less than counter of B. But the vice versa of this is not true. Suppose if we have two events C and D and counter of C is less than counter of D, then we can't deduce that C happens before D. So this is not true, and this is true. So this is one of the problem with Lambert clock. And there is another problem that we cannot find concrete events. What are concrete events? The events which are happening at the same time. Says if we have three processes P1, P2 and P3. So this is one event, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Now these two events we see they are happening at the same time. So these are called concurrent events. Now let us see the implementation of vector clocks. So as you can see, this is a graph, space and time graph, and we are having three processes P1, P2 and P3. These are three processes and event E and F are associated with process P1, C and D are associated with process P2, A and B are associated with process P3. Now the time is flowing from this direction to that direction. Now the initial timestamp of each processes is 0, 0 and 0 for this, and 0, 0 and 0 for this, and 0. Now let us see how these vectors are formed. So the counter of first processes, this vector is formed as P1, P2 and P3. So the counter of process P1 comes in the first place, the counter of process P2 comes in the second place, and the counter of process P3 comes in the third place. So with this we can start filling the vectors of each events. So for says event E1 is for process P1. So we have to increment the counter of process P1 by 1 and remaining process P2 and P3 are 0. So the vector for event E is 1, 0 and 0. Similarly, the event for the vector for event A is 0, 0 and 1. As you can see, the 1 is here because of process P3 and A is an event of process P3. So the counter of P3 is increased. Similarly for process C. Now here is a confusion, as event B is sending a message to event C. So we should have to first calculate the vector of event B. Now event B vector is 0, 0 and 2. Now this is 2 because after A, the B is the second event for process 3. So we increase the counter by 1. So here 2 came. Now a message is sent from process B to process, from event B to event C. So now what we have to do in such cases, when there is more than one vectors, incoming vectors at an event, then what we have to do, we have to select the maximum from each coordinates. So what if there is no vector, incoming vector for process C, this vector is 0, 1 and 0 for process C if B is not there. Now if B is there, we have to calculate for C. Now for process C, the vector, we should have to find the maximum amount 0, 1 1 and 0 0 2. What we have to do, we have to find the maximum coordinate wise. So the resultant would be 0 1 and 2, because the maximum among 0 and 0 is obviously it's a 0, and the maximum among 1 and 0 is obviously it's 1, and 0 and 2 is 2. So the vector for process C is 0 1 2. So we have to write 0 1 and 2. Similarly, for process D, so event D, if we see there is an incoming vector from event E, and this vector is the counter for the counter should be increased by 1, so 0 2 2. This is the incoming vector for from here, and this is the incoming vector from here, which are to be submerged at event D. Now D should be 0 2 2 and 1 0 0. Now we should have to find the maximum among these. 0 and 1 maximum is 1, 0 and 2 maximum is 2, and 0 and 2 it's maximum 2. So the vector for event D is 1 2 2. And similarly for F, it's a simple thing. We should have to just increase the P1 vector. Sorry, P1 counter 2 0 0. Now let us see how the shortcomings or how the drawbacks of Lampert clock are cleared in vector clock. Says if we have two events, E1 and E2. Now how we can deduce that there is a happen before relationship, that is E1 happen before E2. How we can deduce that? So we have to see the vectors of process of event E1 and event E2. Says and if the vector coordinates of E1 says this is a vector V of E1 and vector V of E2, that is equals to I1 I2 and the dash IJ, and this is equals to J1 J2 and up to N. So if all the events says here's IN and JM, so IN must be less than or equals to JM, then we can say that the happen before relationship exists between events E1 and E2. And if this relationship is not satisfied, then we can say that there is no happen before relationships between these two events. So let us see with these examples how we can implement this. Says if we have event A and B, then as we can see, the vector coordinates, the first vector coordinate is 0 and 0, that are equal, so it satisfies. Second, 0 and 0 equals, and the third is 1 and 2, so 1 is less than 2. This implies that A happens before B, so the event A is happening before B. Now if we see with two inter-process events, says B and C, so if we see 0 as C with this coordinate and this coordinate, so let me write separately. C is 0, 1, 2, and B is 0, 0, 2. So 0 is it satisfies, 0 is equal to 0, and 1 is 0 is less than 1, and 2 is equal to 2. B happens before C. We can deduce because 0 is equal to 0, and 0 is less than 1, and 2 is equal to 2. So this satisfies this condition. So thus we can deduce that B happens before C, and we can find with any events. And suppose if we take event A and event F, then event A is equals to 0, 0 and 1 and 2, 0 and 0. Then we can see the relationship is there is no happen for relationship exists between A and event A and event F, as the vector coordinates are not satisfying this condition. All the vector coordinates are not satisfying this condition, because the first vector coordinate of F is greater than A, but the third vector coordinate is less than 1. So there is a mix, there's a mixture of conditions. So this condition should be truly satisfied with all the vector coordinates. Then only we can say that the happen before relationship exists. So that's all. Thank you. Have a nice day.